This is part 2 of cloud computing tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss the state of information technology before virtual machines came into existence. You name any business or industry, airlines, tourism, hotels, software, hardware, manufacturing. It is the applications that power and run these businesses. It's almost impossible for a business to withstand the pressure and competition and thereby sustain in the market without a reliant, performant, and a scalable application. So the fact is, it is the applications that power and run businesses. As far as an application for a business is concerned, there are two main aspects: designing and developing the business application itself, and then hosting this application on a server to make it available for business. So let's discuss what we used to do in the past prior to the technologies like virtual machines and containers came into existence. We'll discuss what virtual machines and containers are and the problems they solve in our next video. So in the past, to host an application, a business needs to procure a physical server. But the question is, how big and fast the server has to be? It's not easy to speculate the demand for the application. So to be on the safe side, businesses procure a high-end server, which obviously costs a lot of money. Now, in addition to this initial capital expense, that is the cost of the physical server, we also have monthly recurring operating expenses like energy cost, for example, that is both for power and cooling. And we also have to hire workforce to maintain the server. Don't forget the operating system license. We have to pay for that as well. In many cases, only a fraction of the server capacity is used, which means obviously a lot of company money is wasted. So we have a physical server. On top of that, we install the operating system. And on top of that, we install our business application. At this point, we have our application up and running and users are able to use it. Now, let's say we're launching a new product or starting another line of business. And obviously, this means we need another application. So we need to procure another physical server and another license for the operating system. And on top of that, we install our second business application. Keep in mind, in addition to the cost of the second physical server, we also have recurring operating expenses. At this point, you might be wondering, can't we install this new application on our existing physical server? Because the first application is only using a fraction of the server capacity anyway. Well, in most cases, we can't. This may be because this new application has different dependencies than the first application. Maybe it needs different version of the framework installed, or maybe it needs a different operating system altogether. Even worse, maybe both applications need access to the same resources or devices, which obviously results in resource conflicts. One way to solve this problem is to buy another physical server. So in the past, there's a one-to-one mapping between an application and a physical server. Every time we need a new business app, we end up buying a new physical server. And keep in mind, these applications are using only a fraction of the server capacity. What a waste of company money. You can see how quickly this can become unwieldy and very expensive for the organizations. This is the model we had until virtualization came into existence. In our next video, we'll discuss what virtual machines and containers are and the problems they solve. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.